diversity and representation. These are things that people love to preach about and always talk about in social media and all these other different platforms. They always want to push that in front of everybody's face and tell you we need more diversity, we need more representation for this community and that community and all these other things. Yet, for black men, the biggest and most successful version of representation in the form of T'Challa has been taken away. There is no other character that even compares to this character on screen in the mainstream for a billion-dollar franchise like that of Black Panther. All that is left is a troubled film like Blade, where Mahershala Ali is pissed because this movie is a complete mess behind the scenes, and we have others taking the hand-me-down, trash bag leftovers of other characters like Falcon trying to be Captain America. Or like War Machine, who has been left as a nothing character for over 10 years, finally getting a movie that was supposed to be a series turned into a movie. That is what we have, bro, for black men. That's what we have for the Marvel Cinematic Universe, because DC still doesn't have anything for black men. They've been sitting here squandering opportunities, getting rid of Cyborg, doing nothing with Jon Stewart, but oh wait, we're going to do a Jon Stewart TV series now. Meanwhile, Marvel was the first ones really out the gate to do a big budget film for T'Challa. Now, it wasn't the first film. Blade came before that, but Blade, in comparison to this, to me personally, there is no contest. The world of Wakanda, everything that surrounds him, the supporting cast, blows things like Whistler out of the water, bro. It blows Abigail out of the water and Hannibal King and all that from Blade Trinity out of the water. There is no comparison when we compare Blade and what he did to what T'Challa did for the black community. There is no comparison. Now, Wesley Snipes did his thing. I will respect that, but still, you get where I'm coming from. Knowing that this character is now gone, effectively, and now we have to settle for somebody else taking the position of Black Panther in the form of spoilers. I'm going to go ahead and let that be known. Spoilers. Shuri is now the new Black Panther, and effectively, T'Challa is now removed from this universe. His death was treated very distastefully, in my personal opinion, because me, watching this movie, my emotions were already taken out of this movie because I've went through my grieving process back in 2020. And for this movie to try and prey upon those grieving feelings again feels very unearned for this movie. This movie did nothing in itself to warrant those emotions from me. So when you can't pull upon those emotions, when you can't use those emotions from me, what do you have to offer me when it comes to logical storytelling? And unfortunately, this movie didn't have much of any of that when it came to justifying T'Challa being killed off in this universe. I have watched this man be considered dead in the first Black Panther film. I've watched him be considered dead in Infinity War. I've watched him come back from the dead in Endgame. And now, after his triumphant return with the whole cinematic universe that were also killed in Infinity War, he is dead again because of reasons. Chadwick Boseman is an actor. He is a man who lived in our world. He is not a fictional character. Why is it that this fictional character has to die off because he passed away? It doesn't make any sense, and it becomes even weirder when I think about the fact that Thunderbolt Ross, played by William Hurt, is already being recast and this man just died. But then there are those who say he was a minor role, he wasn't that big of a deal. Why are we stepping upon the lives of people like that so easily? This man was an OG character from the original part of the MCU that came out in 2008. He was here before Chadwick, and he was here after Chadwick, and yet nobody cares about that because he was a minimalistic side role to certain people. But yet, if he was such a minimalistic role, why are we even recasting? Why can't we just throw the role away? Let it die off with William Hurt. They have no problem recasting William Hurt's role, even though it was so minor, but a gigantic role like that of T'Challa is so easily thrown in the trash so that others can shine. That logic feels backwards to me. Something as big as T'Challa, a franchise like that, bro, you choose to take him out of his own franchise and give me the leftovers. You give me the sidekicks. You give me everything but what I'm really asking for and checking for. And you want me to be cool with that. This franchise already had amazing black female characters all around T'Challa. But to take him out is like, okay, so now it's just all black female characters. And Winston Duke's M'Baku was barely in this second movie. Treated as an afterthought for the most part. He had a few jokes to crack. He had a few little action scenes. But other than that, where was his presence throughout the majority of this movie? He's completely pushed to the side. Michael B. Jordan is dead. Like, where are the black lead characters, bro? The ones who aren't sidekick mantle characters, salivating over trying to take over the role of an established white character, bro. Where are the OG black characters to look up to if we're always talking about representation and all this other junk? Quite frankly, the choice to get rid of T'Challa from his own franchise feels like this is more like the process of checkerboard players attempting to play chess, because they're not really focusing on the long term. They're not focusing on the next 15 to 20 years doing stuff like this. Are they? I'm supposed to sit here and look at, spoilers again, T'Challa Jr. potentially grow up and become Black Panther down the road. Who is T'Challa Jr., bro? I've never heard of this character. I've heard about T'Challa having a son with Storm in an alternate universe, but not this. Nakia and T'Challa have a son way out here in the bushes while he's trying to be the king of Wakanda. So he's an absentee father, keeping secrets like that from his own sister, who apparently loves him so much throughout this whole movie. Every single primary black lead character in this thing borderline dies, bro. All the black men die, except for M'Baku. All the ones that matter, at least. Forrest Whitaker gone. Michael B. Jordan's dad gone. Michael B. Jordan's character, Killmonger, gone. T'Challa's gone. But it's all about representation and equality and all these other things. What do black men have left now when it comes to the mainstream for the MCU? What do we really have, bro? Nothing that compares to T'Challa. Not a single thing. And to try and sit here and act like we should be settling for these other things like Captain Falcon of all things, or War Machine, or Iron Patriot, whatever he chooses to be today or tomorrow. Or settle for Blade, a vampire hunter killing things in the darkness, bro, versus the king of a nation with advanced technology that the Avengers are heavily connected to in the whole world of the MCU, bro. There is no comparison at all, and they took this character away because of an actor. They chose to make this character, who was supposed to be larger than life, smaller than the foot of an actor. They have Chadwick Boseman's foot stepped right on top of T'Challa, bro. T'Challa will never be as big as other characters that exist in pop culture because they have chosen to make this actor forever larger than he will ever be. This character will never be as big as Spider-Man, as Batman or Superman or other characters, because look at what they have done to the biggest black character in the MCU. And all I see now is all these makeshift storytellings of pulling one from an alternate universe like, hey, look, I'm from this other universe over here. My Wakanda people all died. I died over here on your universe. We fit together like a puzzle piece. This is ridiculous, bro. Makeshift storytelling when you could just recast this character and not have to deal with any of these ridiculous choices. But that would make too much sense. And this movie, choosing to have him die in such a distasteful way at the beginning, doesn't make any sense either. It's like that T'Challa. That T'Challa just can't stop dying, bro. Oh, he just came back. He's going to die tomorrow, though. Oh, he just died last week. Probably going to die this week, too. He keeps on dying in this universe. And now they were like, hey, remember that first time when we killed him? Hey, remember when we act like we killed him in the first Black Panther? Hey, like, check this out. Let's kill him again this time, except let's keep it that way. Bro, I don't like any of this stuff, bro. And to be honest, though I love characters like Okoye, though they took away Angela Bassett's Queen Ramonda and they did all these other things, without T'Challa in this universe, without T'Challa in the world of Wakanda, the world of Wakanda is dead to me. It is like trying to check out Gotham City without Batman, bro. You can introduce, sure, I love characters like Nightwing and Red Hood or Batgirl and Damian Wayne, Tim Drake, all this other stuff. But if you take out Bruce Wayne, Batman, and you keep him gone forever, especially this early in the game, I am not going to be feeling what you do in the long term. And that is exactly what they did over here for the world of Wakanda. You took away the biggest piece that holds everything together because you You just can't deal with reality, in my opinion. They couldn't separate the actor from the character when the character should always be bigger than the actor. We are trying to embody characters that are larger than life. Why would we take larger than life characters and make them smaller than a human being? The world of Wakanda is dead to me, bro. And that hurts me to say. I wish it wasn't the case, but how am I supposed to sit here and put a fake smile on my face and act like this world is as interesting as it was when T'Challa was here? It is simply not. Okoye is probably the only thing holding it all together to me, because Shuri surely isn't. And M'Baku by himself surely isn't. Choosing to take T'Challa out of this thing, give him a pointless son for no reason, so that you can say, "Mom, can I get that T'Challa? Son, we don't need T'Challa. We have T'Challa at home." This right here, bro, I'm not feeling this. And to those who love this because we now have a female lead and a female franchise and all that, hey, good for y'all. Cool. But for me and people like me who want to see a primarily black male lead film from a black male lead franchise, as it is in comics and on all other media, to see that taken away so easily, while others are replaced so easily. The world of Wakanda is dead to me, bro. It is what it is. I'm Casey from the cool section. You guys have a good one. And as always, stay safe.